When I was a young TV reporter, when I was first sent to cover stories in Pontefract, I could never understand why it was the whole town seemed to smell of licorice all sorts. But then the locals, who were very kind about my ignorance, began to tell me the story of Pontefract and how licorice has been right at the heart of that story for over 500 years. But if you want to know more, there are two people in this town you've just got to meet. It's Tom Dixon and Norman Blackburn. Well, Tom, tell us first of all, how and why did licorice first come to this town?
Well, there's two stories that conflict each other, actually. One says the knights brought it from the Crusades, from Egypt and those sort of countries. But the most likely story, it was brought by the monks. And when they settled in Pontefract Castle, they found that we had the right depth of soil for growing it. And they brought the original bushes from Spain. So when you suck in the stuff, we used to call it sticks of Spanish. And that's why it got the name sticks of Spanish, because it originated in Spain.
But did it come here as the sort of sweet that we all know, or was it a medicine?
It came as a medicine. They used it for stomach medicines, basically, and chest medicines for cold, and it was used as a medicine. The first man to use it as a sweet was a chemist in the town called Mr. Dunhill. You've obviously heard of Dunhill licorice all sorts. Mm. He was the first man to put it into the sweet context.
But one of the stories I remember being told was that actually it was quite good as an aphrodisiac. It could spice up your love life. Anything in that?
Well, you ought to ask my wife about that, and I don't think she'd agree with you. And I've eaten tons of the damn stuff.
So it may or may not have been an aphrodisiac, but it was certainly quite a good laxative, is it?
It was certainly a good laxative. And Queen Victoria loved the damn stuff, and we used to send her a box of Pontefract cakes down every month to the Isle of Wight, where she had her holiday home. And she loved it. And Napoleon was also addicted to licorice. I don't know whether you knew that. And he lost all his teeth, because licorice is 50 times sweeter than sugar. It's the sweetest thing on God's earth, but diabetics can eat it, funnily enough.
So it was used as a medicine for coughs and colds and chests and that sort of thing?
We grew it, my family grew it, and we never actually grew it for the licorice industry. There were 17 factories at the turn of the century producing sweets in this town. After the Second World War, there was only five, and now there's only two. But we never actually grew it for the sweet industry. All ours went to Boots the chemist in Nottingham, and they used it for stomach and chest medicines and stuff like that.
Just tell me a bit more, though, about why licorice did so well in the soil around here, because there's not much comparison, is there, between Spain and Pontefract?
Our soil, where you're stood now, Geoff, and these are the bushes, is actually very sandy soil, and it has a depth of about 12 foot. Now, you can grow licorice anywhere in the country. It'll grow in your back garden, anywhere, but you won't be able to grow it commercially, because it'll go along the top, where ours go straight down, so we get the roots as thick as my leg. And that takes, as I said, between 4 and 7 years.
So when you plant it, it's up to 7 years before you can actually use it and actually get any return on your capital?
Before you can get any return on your capital. So it became uncommercial, because the Arabs in the world, in Iraq and Iran, they can grow it in 2 years. So they could grow 5 crops to our one, basically. So the butchers virtually out of business.
But nevertheless, there are still factories, are there not, in this town that make licorice? Where do they get it from?
There's two factories now producing licorice products in this town, and one has originated only this last fortnight back to the original owner's grandson, and they will buy theirs, I would assume, from Iraq and Iran and Turkey.
So they're still making sweets?
They're still making licorice sweets and Pontefract cakes.
Now, your family, I think, were licorice farmers, and these fields behind us, they were all your fields, and when you were a kid, they'd have been full of licorice bushes, would they?
These fields were full of licorice bushes. We played in them day and night. We never had to have syrups or things on a Friday night to make us go to the bloody toilet, because we were forever chewing bloody licorice. Yeah, my great-grandfather built this house in 1810. Where he got his money from, I've no idea, but he must have had a bob or two to do it. And my uncle was one of the last licorice growers in the town. I never actually grew it myself, but my family was involved all the time. My wife worked at the factory. She used to pack in the factory, and one day she came home to me very upset and said, "I've packed my engagement ring in a packet of licorice all sorts." Well, to be quite honest, I shouldn't see this on TV, really, but I wasn't really bothered, because I didn't give a right lot for the damn ring. But we've been married now for 50 years, And only last week was our golden wedding, and I bought her an engagement ring, so she's quite happy now. So my connection with licorice and the licorice products has been a big part of my life.
But obviously, from the romantic point of view, you want to make absolutely sure before you buy the girl of your life a decent ring.
Ring, yeah, that's true.
Now, quite a lot of people who watch this programme, they vaguely remember that John Betjeman came here because he wrote a poem and he called The Licorice Fields of Pontefract, and it was obviously about a girl he met who he rather fancied. Can you, Norman, can I bring you in here? Do you remember how this poem, how it starts?
Yes. In the licorice fields of Pontefract, my love and I did meet, and many a blooming licorice bush was growing round our feet. Red hair she had, golden skin, her sulky lips were shaped for sin. Her sturdy legs were flannel slacked, the strongest legs in Pontefract, and so on.
One of the best rhyming couplets he probably ever wrote, that, I think. But he actually wrote that in this field behind us, and it was your auntie fancied, presumably, was it?
My auntie was in this field when he came down, and he said, can I go in your licorice fields, love, and have a look around? She was a typical Yorkshire woman, Geoff. She says, I get this in, lad. Yeah. And he went and he stood in that field over there, and when he came out, he was writing on a piece of paper, and he said, there you are, my dear. She says, that poem's about you. Now, whether it was or not, I don't know. But my auntie had big, thick legs. Because when I was a kid, I would say, bye, my auntie Mabel's got a big backside to be able to get clipped out the goal, told not to be so damn cheeky. So whether it was about her or not, I don't know. Well, everything fits.
We're always told that John Betjeman had a bit of an eye for the ladies. So,
well, I think he had, and he fancied her. I don't think my uncle ever knew, though, that lived here.
Well, it's, you know, on the bench behind us, we've got some implements, and indeed a bit of licorice root to start off with. So that's, after your 7 years, there's your licorice root.
That's your root.
And you crop it. So what do you do with it when you dug that out?
When you dig that out, we used to store it in some cellars under the house. The cellars are still there, they go under the main road here. And then we used to send it up to a refinery in Pontefract. They would press it, all the black juice would come out of it into big baths, and it would solidify. And after a week, that's what it would look like. That is a block of pure licorice.
So that, it's got
the
smell.
I was sniffing a lick.
Yeah. Well, have a lick then. Not often been asked to do this in an interview before, but... Oh, yeah. It's got that taste. It's got the taste.
And that's 50 times sweeter than sugar.
Right.
That's pure licorice.
And the sweets will be made out of that. The medicine will be made out of that.
Everything's made out of that. That is pure block of licorice.
Right. Everything's made out. Now, what about these rather lethal looking cutters you've got? Is that how you'd cut the root?
I never use these because I'm too young, but my father's told me when they used to dig down into the trenches, they'd dig down about 7 foot. The men would get in the trenches with the spades, and then they would clip the roots with that. Yeah. And that's one of the last licorice cropping root cutters in existence. I don't think there's another one in the country but that. So that's very precious to me.
Indeed. Part of it, I suppose, your whole family history
Yeah.
Anyway, do either of you have any licorice about your person? I couldn't really come here and not try it, could I?
Well, you've got just by chance.
Yes.
Hot off the press.
Here's one you made earlier, yes.
Yes. Right, Eve, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Go on, Norman, I'll have one as well, go saddle. Thank you.
And interestingly, are they still stamped with the picture of the castle, is that right?
No, they used to have the broken bridge on, but now they don't. Right. I don't know what they have on them.
Could
now
be a Yorkshire rose,
it could be anything. Right.
Anyway, great pleasure meeting you. Thank you very much indeed. Right.
Lovely.
Good as ever.
Hello and welcome to Pontefract Liquorice Festival. It's a lovely day. There's a lot of people here. There's people selling licorice jewellery, there's licorice plants for sale, and there's this particularly fine licorice beer, which seems to be going down very well. Cheers!
Licorice fields of Pontefract, my love and I did meet, and many a verdant licorice bush was blooming round our feet.
red hair she had, golden skin, her sulky lips.
Yes, this is a licorice plant that Tom Dixon grows in Pontefract. He grows them down on Ferry Bridge Road. They need to have sandy soil, and they wouldn't normally get a flower on them. Not here, but in warm countries they do.
Yeah, the original.
There's only one left.